Hello, I'm Mr. R. Najjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm comparing the rich and Mammon Jewish man who came to Jesus for perfection, begging for perfection, and the spiritual Samaritan man, the perfect in God Samaritan man, contented and merciful. Jesus went to them. They did not come to Jesus. That means Christ Jesus did not come for the Samaritans or the Gentiles, because they were already in the royal kingdom of God. But he came to the Jewish people who loved Mammon and hated God. And so much so, for the sake of Mammon, that the temple rabbis, they killed Christ Jesus, the royal king of our Father God. So thus the rich Jewish man came to Jesus for perfection. He came of his own, seeking perfection, that he had perfection in Mammon. Let's see if he can give me perfection in God also. While Jesus went to the Samaritans to harvest the ripe crop ready for harvesting. Remember, Jesus went to this Samaritan village, whereas the Jewish people, they hate Samaritan. Even today they hate them, you know. They won't go through the Samaritan village in case their hearts get softened with the hospitality of the Samaritans, and they lose their Jewish boy, become a philanthropist instead of money earner, a greedy person. This Samaritan woman, never mind their men. Men are more, you know, spiritual than the, they go for to the rabbi to listen to. But this Samaritan woman, you know, she also had this knowledge, listened to the men discussion, and she also learned a lot. Was so loving God that as soon as Christ Jesus opened his mouth, that I can give you living water. Living water is called ABBAE HAEYAATT in Arabic. So as soon as he told the uttered the word ABBAE HAEYAATT, she engaged Christ Jesus into very deep discussion that even surprised his laborers. Now Christ Jesus had no disciples. Disciples was in rabbis. John the Baptist had a disciple. Rabbis had disciples. Disciples do what they are told to do. Laborers, they work to learn the art of pruning and producing fruit. They are solitary. They are not under the command of anyone. They are free men. Whereas disciples, they are not free men. They are slaves to the rabbis. The laborers, they are sons of the Most High, free men. And they inherit the royal kingdom of God. Disciples being slaves, they are not entitled to the royal kingdom of God, but to the kingdom of heaven, which is outside, seen in law and order. Royal kingdom of God is within your heart. The kingdom of heaven is outside. So she was perfect in the love of God. This Samaritan woman, as they are, you know, they are perfect in the love of God. And in order to give peace to her troubling mind, she had all this knowledge, you know, but still she had some troubling that the Jews say that you reach heaven by worshipping God in the Jerusalem temple, whereas the Samaritans believed in doing good and good. Good turns to people, that means philanthropic, and forget it. which is the philanthropy. In philanthropy, you don't, you know, expect any payment. Then when you don't expect any payment, then you are working for God. When you expect payment, then you are working for Mammon. So these dog-colored peoples, they are not working for God, because at the end of the month, they expect payment from the church purse. As Judas Iscariot used to steal himself without asking anyone. So these dog-colored priests, they dip their hand into the church coffers at the end of the month as their salaries and then their pensions. Then so much, if you add up all together, they are a heavy burden on the churches. In the churches, the people who are there worshipping, they make them to sing songs and all that, that they calling Jesus a Lord. Jesus was an anointed elder brother, serving servant. He was not a Lord. They will call him Lord and God and everything, you know. The people sitting there, they're very happy to pronounce those things, but they don't know that the falsehood are sugar-coated tablets, very sweet when you eat, but when they go inside, then they give you trouble. So that creates sectarian riots, as in Nigeria and other places. These dog-colored people go there, set up the church, and those Mohammedan Muslim mullah, they are also blind guide. So both the blind guide, then they fight with each other and kill each other, as in India during the 1947 partition, people killed each other. So the blindness is great. So we have to weigh, whosoever has Christ in his heart, nobody can touch him, because he is protected by our Father, God. Not a single hair will be removed from your head. And you, as Moses, after he had put on Christ, the burning bush experience was putting on Christ. After putting on Christ, he went to face the Pharaoh without any fear. Before that, he has run away because he killed the soldier. Then he went there to face him and challenge him, you know. So such is the power of Christ. So these temples, say they, you know, the Jewish people are saying that unless you worship in that temple, Jerusalem temple, there is no salvation or no anything, you know. Whereas the Samaritan believed in doing good and forget it, the philanthropy, as he did to the wounded person who were left over by rabbi and Pharisee. So when Christ Jesus told her that time has come, time has come means to worship God in truth of righteousness, which originates from your heart, and spirit of divine love called agape. As the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person displayed, then that doubt or conflict in her mind was made clear for her peace of mind. So when that was conflict was made clear, so then she, everything became clear and she had peace of mind. That is why she engaged Jesus in deep spiritual discussion. So the spirituality in the Samaritan woman was the last husband that was living with her, but dominating no more, as Christ Jesus had ironed or satisfied her doubts out, any questions in her troubled mind. So her mind was no more troubled, you know, because she was now satisfied with the answer she received from Christ Jesus. And that is why she identifies Christ Jesus that you are a prophet, because she was a person of spirit. God is worshipped in spirit and in spirit we know Christ. If you are a man of letter, you cannot know Christ Jesus. As the university professors in Oxford and other, I would go there, they are men of letters. The other day I went there, asked them, who created Adam and Eve? None of them have the answer. In another seminar, I went there and I asked them, the Christ Jesus told Peter, you are the rock over which I will build my temple. What is building on rock and what is building on sand? Now, he was a professor in Oxford University. When he came to my question, he said, I have read in the Bible, building on rock and building on sand, but I don't know what is building on rock, what is building on sand. And if anybody knows, then I told them, give me half a minute, I tell you. So they happened to give me. I told them, when Ananias and Sapphira came to the Peter to give their money, they told him lies. When you tell lie, then you are building your house on sand. But when you are truthful, it is on rock, nobody can shake it. So Ananias and Sapphira, they were killed by Peter. Today the churches are full of liars, because these dog-colored people, they are anti-Christ in Jesus. They have no place to between man and God. We have to make direct approach to God as a royal priest. We ourselves are royal priest. And what the hell these dog-colored people doing? So, sermon delivered by Christ Jesus to her put her mind to rest, and there were no more doubts in her mind. This is displayed in the Orthodox Greek service. When a bishop reads the sermon, there are two persons standing in front of him with candle stands, candle holders, bearing two candles on one stand and three on the other. Now, I went to one of the annual conference of these Russian Orthodox people in High Wycombe, near to my house, 30 miles away. So I went there to watch them, you know, to meet, to take part. And I had my t-shirt on with the logos. So they were doing this service. I see the two men standing in front with two candles and three candles. And they are crossing each other, you know, moving from one place to the other as the bishop was reading the sermon. So as the bishop reads the sermon, the two persons cross each other in a house. Physical body is the house. There are five. Two against three and three against two. This is a Saint Luke, Christ Luke, you know, say, from henceforth, that means in this dark age, there shall be five in a house. Two against three, three against two. None of these university professors knows what are those two and what are those three. As I've explained earlier, the three are of ego. You know, when you are a child, you are led by ego. A natural man is led by ego. So ego is to be subdued before you become a spiritual man. And when you become a spiritual man, you have the Holy Spirit. You can also, in the doubting stage, whether to go for God or for Mammon. When you go for Mammon, the spirit become no more holy, but evil. Evil spirit. So, evil spirited people are greedy and they are merciless. So, there are three are of ego. And two are of mind. Mind is called nafs in Arabic and man in Punjabi. The ego are ego of physical strength, that you are very strong man, a footballer, a wrestler, or other thing, you know, skills. then you are born, you know, birth, that you are a white man, born in a royal family, this and that. So this ego, you know, that you have, your ego of your seed or ego of your birth, then the woman have the ego of beauty. So men also have, of course, this ego, but women are more, you know, of this victim of beauty ego. And this is in Punjabi, in our Sikhism, is continuation of Christianity. In Sikhism, this is called KAAM. KAAM means immorality. Egocentric in wisdom is the second, you know, such as a wrestler, footballer, or etc. display. Now, if you talk to a wrestler, you know, oh, this is not the way you should do it. You should do this way, you know. Hey, I know better than you. So that means his own wisdom is greater than anyone else's. So that is egocentric. He doesn't want to listen to anyone. So he knows better than anyone else. Then that is called KARODHH. KARODHH means anger, as Peter displayed anger to Christ Jesus. Ego of the religious book knowledge, as the Jews display of Torah, which we call HANKAAR, of their Torah, and the university professors of their book knowledge. And the religious knowledge you can acquire two ways. One is through the book reading, as they were doing in Jerusalem. They were reading Torah, telling Christ will come in the house of David and all that. Christ said, what about the one standing in front of you? They could not recognize him because they were all led by ego, HANKAAR, of their book knowledge, or the drunk with the old wine, desiring not the new. Whilst the two are of the mind, called nafs or man in Punjabi, that is still doubting. And if you are in doubting stage, then you have this of mind, you know. They are greed. When you become sensible, you know, Holy Spirit give you, make you sensible, then you think, hey, these people are stupid, you know, once born people, stones, let's fleece them. As some people do by putting on these dog collars, and in their heart they know that they are not working for God but for the greed of Mammon. But they carry on, you know, because nobody is pointing finger at them. So they say it's the fashion of the world. So they are the people of the world. But we in Christ Jesus are not of this world. We go by solitary. We go by our own wisdom, our logical reasoning, which is we drive His word. His word, when you drove by logical reasoning, is called logos, or His word. So they are, you know, when you are mind, your own mind you governed by, then you are led by greed, which we call lobh in Punjabi, as the Jewish rich man displayed. He was a greedy man, you know, this Jewish rich man, the bankers and all that, they display this one. But the Samaritans were always contented with their lots. They did not strive to fleece anyone. They were contented with each other. And there was not much disparity between rich and poor, as in the communist countries was. But now this disparity is appearing and the riots will come. And the second was worldly attachment due to riches. When you have made your riches, you know, money, you have family, and you are proud of your relation, you know, that I have so many people behind me, that means political power, which is can be in your wealth, that you have a big house, the people love you and they vote for you. That is called moh. Moh means worldly attraction, attachment. Remember, Christ Jesus was taken to a high mountain, shown all the worldly kingdoms, that is worldly attachments. Forget about God, worship me, Satan said. And that also you have to be overpowered, you know, not to be attached to these worldly riches. But the Samaritans were not rich. They were simple-minded and people, they were living peacefully and contented. The religious knowledge of the Samaritan was in spirit, as their laws were not written in the books as those of the Jews, but over the tablets of living hearts, the seat of Christ. So, as I said, the Torah was given to the Jews and not to the Gentile. So Gentile have the laws written over their hearts. Jews have laws written in the Torah. They are men of letters, they called people of the book. After the bishop had finished reading the gospel, the bishop is not supposed to read gospel. Gospel is read by our priest, by apostles. But the bishop throw the apostles out into the monastery, and then they burn their monastery and put the apostles before the lions to be eaten alive. Anybody who raised his voice, he was burnt at the stake. So after the bishop had finished reading the gospel, they call it, the two men would stop crossing each other because they had been satisfied with the gospel, but bowed down their heads as a sign of submission to his will, sealing themselves to the service of our submission to the will of our Father God. The last husband of the Samaritan woman that was subdued by the sermon of Christ Jesus. When Christ Jesus gave the sermon, that husband, which was troubling her, you know, spirituality, whether to worship in Jerusalem or what they are doing is right. So Jesus satisfied it. Happily she was listening to Christ Jesus. And our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus was enjoying the feast of his life, feeling no hunger for the physical food, as he enjoyed the very spiritual food with the Samaritan woman. Remember, when I meet a person who is twice born and who listen to me, you know, I feel so happy, you know, to speak with him that I don't want to eat anything. Now, I will stop here because it's getting a bit longer. So in the next, you know, I will give the finishing touch.